Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name is Dr. Mike Hansen, and in this video, I'm going to try to answer as many questions as I can about level of protection versus the Delta variant. So there are a lot of factors that determine how protected you are against the Delta variant. For example, have you had the vaccine? If so, which one have you had? Did you have COVID already? Did you have the COVID vaccine and COVID infection? Are you immunocompromised? If so, did you get the booster shot already? What if you had the vaccines? What will your level of protection be with the booster shot when it's finally available 8 months after you received your first two shots with the mRNA vaccines? So many different variables and still more questions than answers, especially because Delta is still fairly new. But in this video, I'll answer them the best that I can based on the available studies that we have. Now I'm going to skip over the scenario that you've not had COVID or the vaccine, because in that scenario, relatively speaking, you have zero protection. That's a dangerous gamble, and with the odds looking bleaker and bleaker depending on the underlying risk factors that you have. So let's start out with level of protection someone has from previous COVID infection, but they've not had the vaccine. Most people after having a COVID infection, whether it's mild or more severe illness, they appear to have some protection against SARS CoV 2 for about a year. This is based on a study published in Nature that looked at recovered patients. There's also other research showing that vaccinating these people significantly enhanced their immune response to the virus and gave them strong protection against variants of concern, such as the Delta variant. For example, researchers looked at immunity in a group of recovered adult patients 1 month and 6 months after they were infected, and some of them even had a 12-month follow-up blood draw. Now, the first study had 149 participants who were considered to have recovered from COVID. About 10% were hospitalized with COVID. People were excluded from the study if they had long COVID. For example, if they had ongoing or persistent shortness of breath, chest pain, fatigue, fever, or loss of taste or smell. Now, of the original 149 people, 87 returned for the 6-month follow-up, and 63 came back for the 12-month follow-up. 41% ended up getting at least one dose of the mRNA vaccine, and that was an average 40 days before the 12-month follow-up visit. So what were the main takeaways from the study? Compared with 6 months prior, those who were not vaccinated maintained most of their plasma antibodies against the virus's receptor binding domain, the RBD. Also, their plasma, which contains antibodies, had similar neutralizing activity against a non-replicating virus that was engineered with the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein. Now, their memory B cells that produce anti-RBD antibodies were only slightly lower than at the previous visit and had evolved to produce a broader and more potent range of antibodies. However, their plasma had less neutralizing activity against the variants of alpha, beta, iota, and gamma, with the greatest loss of activity against the beta variant that was first detected in South Africa. Compared with unvaccinated participants, those who had received at least one dose of the mRNA vaccine had higher plasma anti-RBD antibodies and a nearly 50-fold increase in neutralizing activity. So what's going on here? For those who've had COVID, vaccination boosts the memory antibodies that develop after infection, causing there to be a more robust response. In this group, neutralizing antibody levels against the variants were higher than the levels observed against the original strain, and also higher compared to fully vaccinated individuals who did not have prior COVID, based on the numbers from these studies. There were also more recent studies that supported this, one study in North America and the other in the UK. It again showed that a single dose of an mRNA vaccine greatly enhances the immune response to COVID variants in patients who've had previous COVID infection. This is something called hybrid immunity. So part of the immunity coming from the immune system from previous COVID infection and the other coming from the vaccine. So about the Delta variant, it's still relatively new, so we're still learning a lot about it. A recent study in France looked at recovered patients' immunity against the Delta variant. Specifically, they looked at unvaccinated healthcare workers, and they appeared to have less protection against the Delta and Beta variants compared with Alpha, and that was about a year after they recovered from mild COVID. So in this group, 88% had neutralizing antibodies against Alpha, and that's compared to 47% against Delta. But for the recovered healthcare workers who had received one dose of either AstraZeneca, Pfizer, or Moderna vaccines, they had a huge increase in protective antibodies against Delta, Beta, and Alpha variants. So the big takeaway here is that vaccinating people who had previous COVID will likely give them much higher protection against Delta and other variants. So how long does immunity last against the Delta variant from vaccination alone? So in that same study from France, they also looked at those who received vaccination but did not have previous COVID infection. They had high neutralizing antibody levels against the Alpha, Beta, and Delta variants 8 to 16 weeks after they received the two-dose vaccine regimen. In a different study that looked at the Pfizer vaccine, which at this point is a study that is a preprint, so it's not yet peer-reviewed, they looked at over 45,000 people worldwide who received the Pfizer vaccine. It apparently continued to show strong protection against serious illness and hospitalization after 6 months, but overall the protection started to wane around the 6-month mark. So according to this July 28th preprint report, the study found that the overall effectiveness of the Pfizer vaccine, it went from 96% to 84%. So it'll be nice to see this study after it's peer-reviewed, but if this turns out to be a high-quality study and the results hold up, it would make sense that a booster is needed. So you have this data that's in the works right now, and then there's more data that the CDC and the Biden administration is basing their decision on based on several recent studies from health systems that have been collecting data on breakthrough infections. These include the New York State Health Department, the Mayo Clinic, and the CDC's reporting system for nursing homes in the United States. And this is in addition to Israel's Ministry of Health abroad. U.S. Surgeon General Dr. Vivek Murthy said at his briefing, "We know that even highly effective vaccines become less effective over time. It's now our clinical judgment that the time to lay out a plan for COVID-19 boosters is now." Now, according to the CDC, the studies don't show any major increases in severe COVID disease, meaning there aren't any major increases in hospitalizations and deaths in fully vaccinated people. But the data from Israel suggests an increased risk of severe disease among those vaccinated early. So the way that I interpret that is the first group of people to receive the vaccines back in December of 2020, people like myself, healthcare workers, the protective antibodies likely will lose or start to become less effective around that 8-month mark. It's really all about anticipation and being proactive and not reactive. So that's why there's a plan to get these boosters in place. So starting in September, the booster shots are coming for those who receive the mRNA vaccines. So 8 months from the time you received that vaccine, that's when it's going to be available. So this does not apply to those who are immunocompromised because the third booster shot is already available for them now. And as far as level of protection in immunocompromised people, that's something I discuss in further detail in my last video, which you can see here. So a lot of people are asking, if we need boosters soon, does that mean I'm no longer safe after just 2 doses? No, anyone who's fully vaccinated is still very well protected from getting seriously ill from COVID. The anticipation is that once you hit that 8-month mark, the antibodies are going to start to wane and they won't be as effective. So what about for people who've had the Johnson & Johnson vaccine? For now, the booster shots are being advised only for the mRNA vaccines, but a separate booster for that Johnson & Johnson vaccine is likely coming soon once more data is available. Some people want to know, what do federal agencies have to do to approve the booster before September 20th? In my opinion, there's a good chance that the FDA will grant full approval to Pfizer and Moderna for the 2 doses, probably sometime in the next few weeks, and then follow that up with an EUA for the booster dose. But that's just speculation on my part. It's also possible that the FDA delays full approval and then give later full approval for all 3 at the same time. Either way, it's going to be the same process as when it granted EUA for the mRNA and the Johnson & Johnson vaccines. What I want to see is the data from these studies showing the numbers that the booster is both safe and effective. Because without that, how can we move forward with the booster? What about the flu shot? When will that be given if you're also getting the booster shot? So far, there aren't any guidelines on this from the CDC, mainly because it hasn't been studied. I think you can expect to see a recommendation for any COVID shot, whether that be the booster or the regular vaccine, to be given at least a month apart from the flu shot. Another question is, weren't they supposed to tweak the booster shot to accommodate the new variants? So as of right now, the booster shot is going to be the same as the first doses or the first 2 doses and not genetically tweaked to accommodate the new strains such as Delta. Why? Most likely because the booster's job will be to simply boost the current immune system to get maximum protection against these strains. Until you have a variant that is escaping the vaccines, meaning lots of breakthrough infections that are causing lots of hospitalizations and deaths, there likely isn't going to be a need to genetically tweak the current vaccine. But of course, this can change with time if a new variant proves to be escaping the current vaccines. So in summary, what would be your level of protection against the Delta variant? If you had COVID, your level of protection is probably mediocre, but will likely fade with time. If you had just the vaccines, it's probably more of the same, but stronger protection. If you had COVID and the vaccine, your protection is likely through the roof and probably wouldn't need a booster anytime soon, but that is strictly my opinion at the time of me making this video. Because that level of protection would likely be the same as someone who's not had COVID, but had the mRNA vaccines in addition to the booster. But time will tell, and this is being studied as we speak.